Hello everyone, welcome to Lukman IAS. Today we are going to have the Hindu analysis of 28th February 2021. So before starting the lecture, let me give you significance of the day. Today is National Science Day that we celebrate to commemorate the day of discovery of Raman effect by C.V. Raman. For that discovery, he was awarded Nobel Prize in Physics, and that is great achievement. One of the great achievement in terms of science for India and Indians. Okay, so that's why we celebrate National Science Day. The sole major objective of National Science Day is to disseminate the knowledge of science and spread the scientific temper, at the same time use of science for welfare of the society, welfare of the people. Okay, so yes, let us see which are the important articles from today's The Hindu newspaper. Yes, these are the important articles for mains purpose and these are for prelims purpose. As we know that Sunday's newspaper, two important pages, one is science and technology page and other is FAQ page. Largely the articles on those page relate to our examination syllabus. Okay, so yes, let us take overview. New rules for social media, OTT, over the top platforms. So yes, earlier on Friday, 26th February, we have looked into the release of these guidelines. Today also we will talk about the detailed provisions here and what are the criticisms regarding it. So on FAQ page, you find this article from Polity and Governance in GS2 paper. India, Bangladesh agreed to speed up border fencing. Now this is good development in terms of internal security or the border management. Okay, so it is a part of syllabus in your GS3 paper, internal security part, right? So for that purpose, here recently there was the bilateral talks between home secretaries of India and Bangladesh, and they have agreed to speed up the border fencing. Okay, so from IR follow up, bilateral relations follow up, mains examination. For prelims examination, IISER Kolkata organization or institute scientists simulate Mars on the computer, suggest how it lost its atmosphere. So yes, they have given insights into how Mars, which had earlier its atmosphere but now wiped out, the reason behind or the phenomenon that happened there, it is giving some insights into that. From geography part, you need to know about this. Then footfall in flurry, tracking elusive snow leopard in Himachal. Yes, so one of the study conducted by the scientists here, they have calculated the number of snow leopards in Himachal Pradesh. Okay, so it is giving that number, but for our examination, prelims examination, yes, the basic information about snow leopard habitat, natural habitat, and then threats and IUCN conservation status. Then PM calls for e-marketing of Channapatna toys. So from art and culture and geography mapping part, the location of this Channapatna in Karnataka. Okay, so yes, UPC is asking such kind of question from art and culture and geography mapping, match the following kind of question. So we'll see about that particular issue here. Yes, now let us go into details of all these articles. First, new rules for social media OTT platform. So on FAQ page number 11, the article is giving details of all the guidelines under this IT rules amendment 2021. Okay, and these are the guidelines, or we can say ethical code for intermediaries and social media platforms. Okay, so under these guidelines, there are different kinds of guidelines for social media companies, and in that also some of the big social media platforms, like we have what you can say WhatsApp or other such platforms are there, social media platform, Facebook is there, and there are other OTT platforms, or we can say over the top video streaming platforms like Netflix, Amazon Video, right? So Prime Video, all these are the OTT platform. At the same time, the other such digital platform includes the digital news, or we can say media, digital media or digital news sites, or those platforms. So all of these are covered here, and now they have to adhere to certain ethical code of conduct. And surely if a person finds that or have some kind of grievances about one particular platform not adhering to that code of conduct or ethical code, So there can be a grievance redressal mechanism, and yes, they have provided different stages here, the three-tier grievance redressal mechanism for that resolution. But before going into that, what are the provisions for big social media companies or social media platforms? They have to appoint grievance officer so as to address the grievances of users of those platforms. Okay. And then the big social media company have to appoint the chief compliance officer. So what is chief compliance officer? In this case, it is basically about compliance with rules and regulation and laws of the government of India. So that officer will be responsible for ensuring the compliance to legal aspects in the country. Okay, and then there will be nodal officer too, and that nodal officer will be a contact person for 24/7 coordination contact with the government authorities. Okay, so this is how three important personalities or officers have to be appointed by all these companies. First, we can say grievance redressal, grievance officer we can say. Second is chief compliance officer, third is nodal officer or nodal person, right? And along with that, there are some additional we can say criterias or the burden have been put on those companies, especially when we talk about finding the originator of the any particular content that has been asked by the courts or the government. Okay, so judicial order may require to find the first originator of the information, and now these companies or those platforms, they have to do this by themselves. Okay, so this is how the additional burden has been created on the social media company. We can say that it is kind of regulation, or regulatory guidelines. And then for other such platforms like publishers of news and current affairs, video streaming apps, there is three-tier structure of grievance redressal. How this works, you can see here. Let us try to understand. It is three-tier, three-level, three levels are given. What is at level 1? Grievance redressal system at level of OTT provider or each OTT provider. Okay, so these companies, these OTT providers, they will have their own in-house grievance redressal mechanism system in place, and the person who is bringing these grievances to it for 15 days, within 15 days they have to solve this. If the complainant or grievance is not satisfactorily solved, he can go to level 2 of the grievance redressal mechanism, and at the level 2, the appeals can be looked into by self-regulatory body. Now this self-regulatory body is collectively formed by all OTT platforms coming together, and this must be headed by we can say that retired Chief Justice of India or Supreme Court Justice, or we can say expert in media or journalism. So having some expertise knowledge in this field, so they are to be appointed as head of this self-regulatory body. Again, here in first two levels, there is no role of the government. Try to understand this. Now the government comes into the picture at level 3. If the person who is let's say having grievances is not satisfied by the result of first two levels in this mechanism, then he can appeal to this third level oversight mechanism, where the government is having this oversight mechanism with the help of interdepartmental or interministerial committee, and that committee will look into the appeals from level 2. This is how the three-tier grievance redressal mechanism works. So it is, government is calling it as soft touch regulation. Okay, so yes, the other provisions like how these ethical code or these digital platforms are supposed to adhere to ethical code, and what is this ethical code, code of ethics, which is listed in the appendix of the rules. So it includes this code of ethics like norms of journalistic conduct as prescribed by PCI, Press Council of India, or we can say that the negative list of the content which is not to be published. Okay, basically it is talking about the reasonable restrictions that are there in our constitution under Article 19. Okay, so reasonable restrictions to exercise the rights given under Article 19. Okay, so that's why we have to understand that these comes under reasonable restrictions. And it also requires streaming services to classify the content on the basis of its nature and time. So yes, surely we can understand that, like universal access, or we can say that those who are having 12 plus age or 16 plus age, 18 plus age, accordingly they have to categorize the content and that have to be continuously displayed on the screen, right? Yes. And then what is the context of these rules that are framed by the government here? The context we can understand, in recent times there have been always questioning about the kind of content that has been live streamed, or sorry, not live streamed, we can say video streamed on this OTT platform, and to some extent many instances of harming the religious sentiments or threat to order in the society, or a public morality kind of concept. Yes, from time to time, even Supreme Court in one of the judgment, that case involving Sudarshan TV, has said that the government should come up with suggestions for self-regulatory or self-regulation of mechanism for electronic media, right? So yes, the government had that time said that there is need of regulation of such platforms, and now has come up with such guidelines. Okay, so yes, at the same time, recently we have seen how there was spat between government and the Twitter company, as the government asked to suspend, remove some of the content, and it's suspend the accounts of members of Twitter company. And initially yes, it accepted, but later on immediately it revoked the suspension. So we can say that the Twitter company also partially implemented that order of the government. Okay, so this is how there has been continuous conflict between this big social media giants, we can say that, and the sovereign bodies or decision makers of the countries, like government or legislatures. Okay, and that's why the government has come up with these guidelines. Now we have to also understand that what changes from the earlier rules have been made. So yes, now the scope of IT rules have been expanded here, that IT Act 2000 has been expanded here. Earlier, we can understand that there was no inclusion of digital news platforms or social media platforms per se directly giving guidelines. So digital news platforms over OTT platforms were not included. Now the definition of intermediaries is broadened further by including these platforms. At the same time, under Section 79 of the IT Act, the intermediaries are not liable to user-generated content, provided they adhere to these rules. So these rules are now have been tightened. Strict rules have been made, and they have to adhere to these rules, otherwise they may be made liable for the content on that particular platform. Right. Now, what are the criticisms of these rules? Yes, criticism, the foremost criticism we can understand here, these rules have been framed, yes, without any discussion in the parliament. Rather, the executive action have been taken, and the scope of the act have been increased by the executive action itself and not by the legislative. Second is that surely it will have the negative manifestations on creativity and freedom of speech and expression. Why? Because yes, all these OTT platforms have helped to promote the creativity, though there are some instances of we can say, or negative instances, but largely it has promoted creativity. And as we have seen, many such documentaries, web series on social issues have flourished on those OTT platforms. Even it had promoted the talent, which was not promoted by the mainstream film industry. Yes. So this is the criticism. At the same time, it increases the potential for censorship and surveillance. Basically, in the name of reasonable restrictions under Article 19, the government may increase the censorship and surveillance over these expression freedom, or we can say speech and expression platforms. Okay, digital platforms. So in criticism you can write this. Now look at the question that can be asked here. Discuss the provisions of IT rules 2021. Why are the rules being criticized by certain sections of society? So basically you need to know, first thing, freedom of speech and expression, creativity and art, and freedom of expression. Second thing you need to know that since independence, the approach largely has been that the print media or electronic media, the approach have been self-regulation or promoting such kind of regulation. However, what happened is what happens at present is the kind of introduction of regulation or its role has been increased. Government's role have been increased in this particular mechanism of soft touch regulation by the government. Okay, so this is how you need to write down or attempt this question from this discussion. Okay, next article here, India and Bangladesh agree to speed up border fencing. Now you need to understand that last year itself there was question in 2020 mains examination internal security GS3 paper, what are the border challenges, or we can say the challenges in effective border management along the three countries, Pakistan, Myanmar and Bangladesh. So yes, the article itself mentions some of the challenges that are there. What are these challenges along the border of Bangladesh? First and foremost, you need to know that there is continuously let's say smuggling of fake Indian currency from that side. At the same time, you have to understand that anti-India activities used to be carried out on the soil of Bangladesh. Now Bangladesh government, Sheikh Hasina government in the Bangladesh have helped to eliminate such kind of anti-India activities and those we can say that elements from its soil. Okay, and both countries have agreed for and appreciated that efforts. Second thing you need to understand that fencing is very difficult in that along that border. Why fencing is difficult? Because the porous border. Now why porous border? Because of river courses are frequently changing, and because of that the fencing cannot be done from end to end. Okay, so river course continuously changes and because of that the fencing is not possible. At the same time, other challenge you need to know that the migrants challenge, and then you need to know that there is Rohingya refugees problem, right? So all these are the problems. Along with that, there is also cattle trafficking and human trafficking cases along the India-Bangladesh border. Okay, so these are the challenges. Obviously, in that answer, you should have mentioned this. You could have drawn the map of India and showing the borders with these three countries, and there itself you could have mentioned all these challenges. Now, what are the developments that have happened here in 19th Home Secretary level talks between India and Bangladesh? Yes, both countries are, let's say they have agreed to speed up the fencing mechanism that have been agreed by heads of the government, prime ministers of both countries. Yes, and then at the same time they also reaffirmed that they will not allow territory of either country to be used for any activity inimical to others interest, right? At the same time they have appreciated the effective functioning of coordinated border management plan, CBMP. Now you need to know about this. India Bangladesh has this coordinated border management plan. You can give this as reference for India China border management. How, why? Because it has been effective. Okay, so coordinated border management plan to control the illegal cross border activities and was appreciated by both sides. So yes, it can be used for Myanmar it can be used for Nepal, it can be used for Pakistan. So this is actually one of the good mechanism for effective border management. Fine. So from internal security perspective, border management GS3 paper, this is the follow up here. Now for prelims related developments, science and technology page. Yes, IISER Kolkata, so Indian Institution for Science Education and Research. Now scientists at this institution have suggested, or let's say given the explanation for removal of the atmosphere in the Mars that was present in early history of the planet, and now it is not present. So yes, what is this mechanism? You need to understand. It was Mars intrinsic magnetic dynamo, which by shielding its atmosphere from sun's solar wind, protected its atmosphere. Now this is the exact mechanism that our Earth's magnetic dynamo, or this dynamo, has effect on this solar winds. It protects its atmosphere from wiping out by the solar winds. You need to know about this. Okay, so yes, early atmosphere was protected by its own dynamo, magnetic dynamo. However, when this magnetic dynamo stopped or ceased to work, then what happened is the solar winds now slowly wiped out its atmosphere. Okay, so yes, when the magnetic dynamo switched off, the atmosphere slowly was eroded by solar winds, and at present the scanty atmosphere, remnants of that atmosphere, are remaining there, right? So this is how you need to know about from geography part explanation here. This is also related to Earth, or we can say geomagnetism. The same mechanism is responsible. Earth's atmosphere is also protected from solar winds. Okay, yes, moving on. Footfall in flurry, tracking the elusive snow leopard in Himachal. Okay, so yes, one of the study of counting the snow leopards in Himachal Pradesh. At present, there are 73 such snow leopards there in Himachal Pradesh, where districts of Lahul Spiti and Kinnaur district. Okay, now we know that this is the snow leopard lives in the high altitude region. We can say alpine and subalpine zones, elevation 3000 to 4500. And the Himalayan region, wherein from Afghanistan to Pakistan, then Tibetan Plateau, then China, Nepal, all these countries have some population along with Siberia, Mongolia, okay, of snow leopard. In India, it is found in five states. We can say now a union territory of Jammu Kashmir, Ladakh, Himachal Pradesh, Sikkim, Uttarakhand, Sikkim, Arunachal Pradesh. Okay, so these are the states where the snow leopard population is naturally found. Now, what are the threats? Obviously, yes, poaching, habitat destruction following infrastructure development, these are the major threats. And yes, IUCN status at present, it is vulnerable. In 2017, IUCN took decision to change its status from endangered to vulnerable. You need to know the contemporary developments also. So for that purpose, this much information is sufficient. Okay, it is also known as AUNS. Okay, this snow leopard, cat family. Now practice prelims MCQ. So such kind of question statements UPSC generally gives about snow leopard. It is categorized as vulnerable. So you have to check the incorrect statements. But this is correct statement, vulnerable. It is found only in India. Incorrect. It is also found in Afghanistan, Pakistan, China, Siberia, Tibetan region. Right. Yes, it is found only in Himachal Pradesh and Ladakh region of India. No, it is also found in Sikkim, Uttarakhand, or we can say Arunachal Pradesh also. Right. So this is also incorrect. So answer should be 2 and 3. Incorrect statement they are asking. Okay. So this is how generally, on an average, it is accepted that when we have only in statement, UPSC asks every year such kind of statement, only, the answer is largely incorrect. Okay, सो रॉन्ग स्टेटमेंट होता है वो लार्जली. एंड लास्टली यस, प्राइम मिनिस्टर कॉल्स फॉर ई मार्केटिंग ऑफ चन्नपटना टॉयज. नाउ चन्नपटना टॉयज आर वेरी फेमस. इट इज टॉय टाउन ऑफ कर्नाटका. ओके, इट इज लोकेटेड हियर नियर बैंगलोर. सो दिस प्लेस इज नियर बैंगलोर एंड चन्नपटना इज वेरी फेमस. फ्रॉम लास्ट 200 ईयर्स द आर्टिसंस इन दैट रीजन आर मेकिंग वुडन टॉयज. द गवर्नमेंट हैड ऑलरेडी गिवन द ज्योग्राफिकल इंडिकेशन टैग GI टैग to those toys, and therefore now in one of the virtual address to these artisans here, basically virtual inauguration of India Toy Fair 2021 in New Delhi. This was inaugurated by Prime Minister. India Toy Fair 2021 in New Delhi. Okay, and in that the Channapatna, the location here, so there can be question like Channapatna sometimes was in news, or it was in news related to which of the following. So it is toy town. Okay, so toy making artisans since last 200 years. Basically it was dated back to reign of Tipu Sultan, who invited these artisans from Persia. Okay, and then they flourished in that region. Art of wooden toy making, very famous, you can see here like this. Okay, so from miscellaneous parts, art and culture part, you need to know at the same time location also. Fine? Yes. So these were important articles from today's The Hindu newspaper. अगर आपको ये वीडियो पसंद आया हो तो इसको लाइक कीजिए, शेयर कीजिए हमारे अपने फ्रेंड्स के साथ में, और साथ ही साथ हमें आपका फीडबैक बताइए कमेंट सेक्शन में, और इसको हमारे चैनल को सब्सक्राइब भी कीजिए. फॉर फर्दर इन्फॉर्मेशन ऑन एडिटोरियल डिस्कशन क्लासेस और ED क्लासेस wherein in-depth analysis of mains related issues and articles is done by Ansari sir and team, you can contact Lukman IAS. Thank you.